Listen. And this is what the Bible was saying in Proverbs 23, verse 7. It says, as a man thinketh in his what? So he, that means your reality is based on your mindset. Your reality is not what happens. Your reality is based on your mindset. If you want to have better outcomes, expand your perspective. If you want to have greater results, expand your perspective. Bible says, yes, it was during the conversion. Apostle Simon used the scripture, Mark 6, verse 7. It says, and these signs shall follow them what? That means that there are certain signs that follow belief pattern. There are certain signs that follow what you have, your perspective. There are certain signs that follow. That means if you believe this way, there are certain things that will follow you because you believe this way. Now, how are our belief system formed? Two things primarily. The first thing is by our family. Say family. Say family. The second thing is by our environment. Say environment. Sorry, let me backtrack a bit. I said your reality is your what? Perspective. And that perspective now determines your what? Outcome. And your perspective is shaped by what? Your family and your environment. Listen, by the time a child is 6 years old, the person's view of life is already formed. Right? It's just been added on. Everything else you see through your narrow perspective. Let me give you this very funny example. If you know when you're frying plantain in your house, you put salt, put up your hand. You put salt when frying plantain. You put salt when frying plantain. You generally, I'm not saying. Put your hand down. Wait. If you don't put salt, raise up your hand. More people don't put salt. Abi, listen. You know, listen. Let me. Under heaven, I just knew this thing yesterday. In my house, you always. Why would I fry plantain without salt? Ah. Listen. Our topic is not plantain. Maybe Pastor Joel will have a dodo service. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Listen. That means some of us, yeah. Now, I'm sorry for putting you on the spot though, right? So I'm dating somebody, right? And we come from two different realities of life. I remember the first time, I don't believe that Pastor Daniel is popular. Pastor Daniel Olamide is popular. You know his perspective. Some people don't know who he is. She said, come and see. God, she knew about Pastor Dio. I said, come and see Peter. I said, who is Peter? Who is this thing? She met him, said, hello, Daniel. How are you? Because our behaviors is shaped by what we know. You behave like a goat because you think like a goat. You can't out. It's not you. Sorry. Listen, you can't act outside your natural. See, a goat will be. What does goat do? Sorry, I don't know what they do. Meh. Why? Because a goat, that is his goat, but that's his nature, that is perspective. Listen. So most of us, I read an article about, you know, this half. If you put a glass of water into half, right? Half empty and full. So we all know these things, but they brought some random people, very young people. Some people grew up in them Kidwaya's them household, all these other dollar people. Some people grew up with my own household, normal people. And they asked them, and listen, what happened? They put the glass and they were pouring the water. And they stopped, right? And they gave them a list of words, right, to describe what they felt. The people that came from poor background tilted towards the thing is about to finish. Because all their life, their perspective is about it will soon finish. The people that came from them affluent background, they were saying that the person is not put enough. It's not completely full. The person stopped. Those are the words the person put. Why? Because they came from a what? Perspective. And most of us, sorry to say, our foundation is shaking back. What we know about life is faulty. But there's a good news. Say there's a good news. Let's go to our Bibles to Revelation 5, 9 to 10. Ah! This scripture gives me joy. Revelation 5, 9 to 10. I want everybody to do together. Baby boys and baby girls in media. Please, if you read your Bible, KJV, I like KJV. One, if you have a Bible, Revelation 5, 9 to 10. One, two, three, go. And they sung a new song, saying, thou art worthy to take the book and to open the seal thereof. For thou was slain, and as what? And as what? By the blood out of every kindred, Yoruba, out of every tongue, Igbo, out of every people, out of every nation, thank God, Nigeria. Verse 10. And has made us kings and priests that we may reign with him. That means I am my family. Listen, I said family is what determines how you perceive things. Your family, God says, if you are a child of God, born again, he said he has redeemed you out of Yoruba, out of Okitipupa, out of Ibadan, out of Manabra, out of Okija, out of the north, out of everywhere, and he has brought you into Zion. Say Zion. Say Zion. Type your name 5 times. Say Zion. Say Zion, 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 Zion. Say Zion. I am a citizen of Zion. Say Zion. Listen, and God brought us out of our father's house, and he made us into Zion. And the Bible says in John 14 verse 2, he said, listen, no, baby boys and baby girls, he said, in my father's house there are many mansions there. I go somewhere to prepare a place for you. Listen, in his father's house there are many mansions. So in one of the mansions there's now one place for you. Do you know that the Old Testament is a mirror of the New Testament? When Moses did the day of the cross, it was a symbol of Jesus who died on the what? On the cross. Right? That means what we are doing now also mirrors what will happen in heaven. Marriage. So everything is a mirror. Listen, the Bible says in my father's house. So now let's bring it backward. That means when God created you, he said, this girl, Moyo, sorry, how to jab you? Where are you from? Hello, give me your father's village. Yeah? Oh, who's from a village? Who have village? Or you're in another village? Where? I'll jab you. Iropora. Where's Iropora? Ekiti. Listen. So, in heaven, listen, the Bible says, before you were formed, I knew you. He said, where is this? The one of the least, Angel Michael. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. On that one day, where is she going to? Nigeria. Everyone say, yay. The angel say, oh. I say, yeah, put her there. He said, but if we take her there, our perspective will be changed. Right? So we need to plant a family for her. He said, don't worry. Let's go and meet one man. His name is Iya Deboye. Let him start the church called RCCG. And in RCCG, let him start a movement called LSC. And in LSC, let him start in VI. But this girl living where are you living? Somewhere close by here. He said, no. God, let them move from VI. And they came here. In my father's house, there are many mansions there. So God was deliberate and he created a place called LSC for you. He has redeemed us out of every tribe, out of everything. So we are in Zion. And in Zion, where your place is LSC. Let me tell you something. You don't choose your family. Your family chooses you. Did you wake up and say, I want to be Ogun? I can say I want to be Dangote. Or Buhari. No, not Buhari. I like Buhari. I'll be president's son. But I want to be a Christian. So, Oshibanjo. The job at him, not too much. I can say enjoy. Right? Because you don't choose your family. When God planted Adam, I say, Adam, do you want to say Eden or Galilee? No. He said he planted Adam and he's my pastor now. I've a bit. Listen. He planted Adam and put him where? He put him in the garden. Baba, sit down there. Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, I don't believe in circumstance. You are here because this is home. Touch your neighbor, say, this is home. This is where God has packaged that, if this girl go, that went to law school in the north and serving in Imo, if she goes, we need to create a system where her perspective can be changed, where she can learn the rudimentals of God, where she can learn foundations, where she can learn the core values of character, excellence, and fire, of being anointed, being rich, and being dominating. And God created this church. And no, it's not finished. And God said, who will now pastor this church? Because listen, I will put this thing. He said, who will pastor this thing? And he said, there's one guy. He has full hair. He's doing bad boy in Bangkok. We are bringing him. He's that one. Listen, God doesn't make mistakes in leadership. This man right here, whether you like it or not, before you were formed, is your daddy, your pastor, is LSC Omole Adiola Aboraji Emmanuel. Now listen, my time is up. I'm not going to preach my sermon. I'm very serious now. Let me quickly rush. So, now, why are you not here? You have come here. God said you are here to what? Change your perspective. Because if only you can, your perspective can increase. Once you see, there are some things that you don't know you have access to until somebody tells you you have access to it. There's some jobs you say, I cannot apply for this job. It's just because you don't know anybody. No, God said, God said, testimony. So there are three things that God wants us to do for you and shape your mindset. The first one, and that symbolizes what we are. Everyone say, we are anointed. Say, we are anointed. Slap your neighbor three times. Say, we are anointed. Now, quickly, what does being anointed means? There's no time, no time, no time. Say, no time. Now, anointing means smell with oil. Say, smell with oil. Basically, pour oil on the person's body. Simple. That's anointing. Now, but in the Old Testament, anointing was only for what? Kings and priests. When they want to appoint somebody, right, for an assignment, is that a king or a priest? They pour oil. Because anointing means smell with oil. Anointing means oil. Anointing oil is tautology. Because anointing means smell with oil. Listen, so it was only for kings and priests in the Old Testament. But remember the scripture we read, Revelation 5, 9 to 10. It said, he has made us what? He has made us what? He has made us what? That means anointing is for me. Say, anointing is for me. Say, I am a candidate for anointing. Now, what is the anointing? Very quickly. The anointing is the Holy Ghost. Say, the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost. The Bible says, how God anointed who? Jesus Christ. With what? So what was used to anoint him? The Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is the anointing. And the Bible says, he that is born again, he received the Holy Ghost. That means I have anointing. Anointing lives inside of me. I'm sorry. Anointing flows out from me. Kai, it's not a song. Anointing lives inside of me. It's inside you, whether you like it or not. Anointing flow. Kai. Listen, until you're anointed, you cannot act. Listen, you will be a king in waiting. This Omoba Shola, Oluwori, he has been king in waiting since December last year. They appointed him when? August this year. Because until you are anointed, you are a king in waiting. Most of us, yes, God has called us king and priest. But David has been a king since. But until he was anointed, he did not ascend the throne. Even Jesus, the Bible says, I'll not be saying the story I'm saying. Listen, the Bible says, and in Luke 4 verse 18, he said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has what? Anointed me. Not until Jesus became anointed, he did not go out and do anything. So you can have all the giftings, everything. If you are not anointed, you are not enabled to go. Anointing means empowerment to go. So empowerment to go. Now, what is in the Holy Ghost? We know the anointing is the Holy Ghost, right? The anointing is the what? The anointing is the what? Holy Ghost. Revelations 4, verse 5. Revelations 4, verse 5. Now, please listen very carefully. If we have the reading a lot of scriptures. He said, now listen, and out of the throne proceeded what? Lightning and what? And what? Continue. And there were seven lamps of, and seven. Now people say, ah, Holy Spirit are seven. Me, I don't know that one. No. Revelation 5 verse 6. Let me explain what the seven spirit of God means. In number 5, you see the seven manifolds or the seven expressions. It's one Holy Ghost, one Spirit, one Lord, one. But seven expressions. Now, verse 5, Revelation 5 verse 6. Revelation 5 verse 6. It says, now, I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne of the four beasts, and in the midst of the elders, stood a lamp. The lamp, who is the lamp? Who is the lamp? Answer now. Only group 3 is giving me vibes. Yeah, sorry, Pele. As it has been slain, having what? Seven horns and seven eyes. Which are the seven? So that means Jesus operated with the full seven dimensions. What are these dimensions? Isaiah 11 verse 1. Isaiah 11 verse 1. He was prophesied. Isaiah 11 verse 1. Please follow me. Pay attention. Because most of us will know why we are even like something we don't know. Listen, he said, and there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and the branch shall grow out of the roots. Verse 2. Listen. And the Spirit. Now, it was not about Jesus. He said, this is what will happen in Jesus. He said, and the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him. He said, Spirit of the Lord. That is manifestation. What? One. Number 2. Spirit of wisdom. Say, Spirit of wisdom. 2. Spirit of understanding. Say, understanding. 3. Spirit of counsel. Say, Spirit of counsel. 4. Spirit of mind, say spirit of mind. 5. Spirit of knowledge, say spirit of knowledge. Finally, say the spirit of the fear of the Lord. There are 7 of them there. Out of them, 5. Listen, the primary thing that the anointing will do for you, more than anything, is give you wisdom. Listen, spirit of the Lord is not wisdom. Spirit of wisdom is not wisdom. Understand this, does not relate to wisdom. Counsel does not relate to wisdom. 3. Knowledge does not relate to wisdom. Fear of the Lord. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of us. 5. The first thing that the Holy Ghost will do for you, he will give you, make you wise. Wise. If you're not there, you don't have the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is meant to make you wise. As LSE members, the first manifestation is supernatural wisdom and creative insight. That's what the Holy Ghost does. He brings wisdom, counsel, understanding, mind, the fear of God. Number 2. Mind. Bible says, they that know, that God, they shall be what? And do what? That means you need strength to do exploit. You need strength to do exploit. He says, if you are diligent, you stand before what? Kings, and not before what? That means you need strength, a form of strength, mental strength, emotional strength, physical strength, and everything is embedded in the Holy Ghost. If you are tired, if you are depressed, that is who we are. We are anointed. You should not be feeling depressed because you have the Holy Ghost. You are anointed. Say, I'm anointed. We don't have time. Number two, we are rich. Say, we are rich. We are rich. Say, we are rich. Don't be selfish. Say, we. Don't say only you. Say, we. Say, we are rich. What does wealth mean? What does wealth mean? Wealth or riches means having in abundance. Having in abundance. You know, wealth is not just money. There are 3 categories of wealth. Number 1, say relationships. Relationships, say relationships. Listen, if you feed your relationship very well, they will feed you. You are sitting beside gold mine. Gold mine. See, look at the person. Say you are a gold mine. Let me just give a small example. Listen, this is what the Bible says. That he said, don't be weary in doing good because you don't know when your due season will come. Let's do by the other example. By the other, is he was running for counselorship. Ade Smith, where are you? Ade is there. Ade has been friends with Pastor Diola since Ajiz. Badiola is doing local government. I'm not doing jari. Imagine he's not doing, but he did, right? So he supported Pastor Diola. When Pastor Diola became local government chairman, who will appoint our chief of staff? Ade Smith. When he become governor, who will be chief of staff? When he become president, who will become chief of staff? Listen. If you have access to Pastor Diola, start be friend with Pastor Ade Smith. His girlfriend, be good to her. His girlfriend's friend, be good to her. Everybody, listen. Relationship is currency. I'm telling you, you will not have money, but if you have good people one day you will withdraw. Number two, say a good name. Say a good name. The Bible says in Proverbs 22 verse 1, it says, a good name is to be chosen rather than what? This thing busts my head. How? How? Technical, are you ready? How? How can a good name better than riches? How? How? Tell me how. Have good name. Have good name. Baby boy and baby girls, we don't have time, even though I'm rushing. Baby boys and baby girls, are we ready? Media technical experts of the Most High, your loyal highnesses, please, are we ready?
God grant me the leaf of this church.
They are ready.
And dump
so,
me.
Pause. Listen, I will not talk too much. Listen, I will not talk too much. I will just give you this one. If you don't understand it, you need to go to Rio Key. Oh yeah, play.
God grant me the leaf of this church. And dump me in Covenant what? University.
Good
you
name.
Can leave your research center
name.
For me. Everything there will be taken, including the floor.
God grants me
the leaf of this church and dump me in Covenant University. You can leave your research center for me. Everything there will be taken, including the floor. Everything inside there will be taken, including the floor. There is nothing of value that comes from you that does not end. God grants me the leaf of this church and dump me in Covenant University. You can leave your research center for me. Everything there will be taken, including the floor. Everything inside there will be taken, including the floor. There is nothing of value that comes from
you. Don't worry. Thank you, Jerry. That's all. Because they will ask about you.
Build just carry
your name. Build value to your name. Build value to your name. There's nothing of value that comes from you that does not enhance your heart. There's nothing of value that comes from you that does not enhance your words. Build value to your name. Because good name is what? Wealth. Number three, form of money.
Carry worth. God grants me the leaf of this church and dump me in Covenant University. God grants me the leaf of this church and dump me in Covenant University. You can leave your research center for me. Everything there will be taken, including the floor. Everything inside there will be taken, including the floor. There is nothing of value that comes from you that does not enhance your worth. Everything of value from you enhances your worth. Don't just carry a title. Carry worth. Carry worth. The worth of a man is not his title. The worth of a man is in his values. Clinton, no title. George Bush, no title. Barack Obama. The worth of a man is in his name, not in his title. So I see amazing products named with you.
He says, a fool spends everything that he has. It's simple. You know, money, we have said many things. I don't like talking about money. In fact, listen, do we know that we are meant to save and invest? Do we know? Yes or no? Yes or no? We know. But what's our problem?
I get big ear, but I know the hear word.
That's the problem with all of us. All of us. Let me read again, because not here.
I know the hear word.
All of us.
I get coconut head. I get big.
Listen. Proverbs 21 verse 20, Onyeka translation, it is not what you have, it's what you have left that makes you rich. Listen, if you're not saving, if you're not investing, you are a fool. Proverbs 21 verse 20 said so. Number three, we are dominating. Say dominating. Say dominating. Now, what does it mean to dominate? To have control. Say I have control. If I say what about control now, you will say, do I have control? Say to have control. Baby girl, come. Sorry. I will change illustration. I'm not using it. Now, I cannot. No way. Wait, go. Bolu, please come. Bolu, please come. Bolu, come. Sorry, I'm using you. Just run anywhere. Yeah, run. I know I can use you. Hey. I'll never say something, but everybody will laugh at me. Now, I have more control. I look like I have more power than other power than Morris. You beat me. Listen, you cannot subdue what you don't have control over. We cannot be on the same level that I have control over you. I have to have something higher than you. Either excellence or power or knowledge. Before I can dominate you, I must be. Is it my, I don't know. Before I can, what is making noise? It's not me, Shao. Not doing anything. Before I have control over her, I must be what? Above. Okay. Awesome. Can you hear me? We'll continue. Hallelujah. Now, before I have control over her, what will happen? I must be what? Above her. Say above her. Say above her. Now listen. How do we dominate in the kingdom? We dominate. There's this baby girl. Her name is Michelle Obama. Do you know her? Baby girl said that when they go low, we go. See, listen. If you want to have domination over something, you cannot attack darkness with darkness. You must have to go higher and do light to overcome darkness. If someone is hungry, you cannot use anger to dominate hunger. You have to be what? Higher than hunger. Listen, the Bible says, Proverbs 8 verse 15, those that dominate with wisdom. Wisdom said, by me, kings reign. By me, kings reign. By me, kings reign. You dominate anger with what? Joy. You dominate sadness with what? Gladness. You dominate poverty and not having enough by giving. It does not make sense, because when they go low, we dominate by light. He said, by me, wisdom said this. God bless you. Come on, sit down. By me, kings reign. By me, kings reign. Say, we are anointed. Say, we are rich. Say, we are dominating. That is the mindset you should have. That's your perspective. And when you come every Sunday, we enlarge it small, small, until you become everything that God has for you to be. And God has given us a mandate to create families in LSC. Listen, we want to grow together. Because God has given us a mandate that our perspective must change, and our behaviors will change, and our life will change. We will become better and better and bigger. So God gave us a mandate. He says, raise my people to become a family. Because we are a family. Say we are a family. Ushers, you can bring this in now. Say we are a family. Now, God gave us an instruction, and we are moving with this mandate from now on. Land your memorial. Guys, get ready. We are dividing the church into three, as we've already done, right? And we are creating, families. Before we go further, let me just introduce the families that we have. In LSC, from now on, we have three families. Say, the anointed family. Everybody here belongs to the anointed family. Can you shout hallelujah? Say, we have the rich family. The rich family. I say we have the dominating family. Don't get excited. I say we have the anointed family. Wow. We have, please, can we open the shirt and let's wear it on what I'm wearing? Please open it and wear it on what I'm wearing. I know you said, oh, just wear it on top. Don't worry. We are all doing it together. We have the anointed, the rich, and the dominating family. Please, I know it may not size you, it might be smaller, it might be bigger, but we are doing something prophetic. Everybody, open the shirt and let's wear it. I'm not seeing people excited. Can I hear the another family shout and make some noise? make sure you pick your nylons and just put it. Don't put it on the floor. Can the rich family, Omo Olowo, can you shout hallelujah? I think this family has more ginger. Can the dominating family, the dominating, can you shout hallelujah? Sorry, please, for next 2 minutes, can we just wear our shirts? I love this family of God, so close knit, so close knit, knit. Families, is that family to do? They have taken me. Another family, you are too serious. A part of this great family. As to us, we need each other. Don't you know you mean so much to me? I need you to build this family. And you need me to build this family.
This praise family. God.
Praise God. Before we continue, please, can everybody, are we continuing our shirts? Please, we are going to explain further very soon, but I want us to celebrate. I want to see the family that has ginger. It's as if these people are very, they are set, right? I think when I'm joining family, I'll join this family. Because I know that you are too anointed for me, right? Can we go together? Now, please just put after me. If you know this song, repeat. Say, do you really, really, really? I really, really. Do you really, really, really?
I really, really.
Do you really, really, really?
I really, really.
Do you really, really, really?
I really, really.
I really, you, I really, you.
I really know, I really know.
I really, you, I really, you.
I really know, I really know.
Do you really love this family? I
love. In God's presence, say glory. Praise Jesus. Please, can we pass all our nylons to the aisle so that the ushers can come and pick it? Listen.